It's a pretty typical exhaust fan these days for a bathroom. In this case, the light is built into the fan. Sometimes you see just the fan alone. And I think exhaust fans for bathrooms are extremely important. They help keep mold away. They help prolong the life of the paint, of the fixtures, just by keeping the moisture away after showers, especially if you have teenagers in the bathroom, that sort of thing. They tend to take longer showers and really steam up the room. So exhaust fans are very important to making the bathroom last longer and also maintaining the aesthetics of it, so you don't have water dripping down the walls and gathering dirt and that sort of thing. So, but the devil is in the details, and the ductwork for exhaust fans is the most important part of it. So I want to talk about that and the best ways of doing it. Okay, we're here in the shop. I'm going to try to explain some of the details about the ductwork that that I think are important. Typically, you have this fan here, and sometimes there's a light, sometimes not. And there's a box that is in the attic area, which holds the electric and the fan and that kind of thing. And then there's a port here, usually a 4-inch port, that goes to the ductwork, and then the ductwork has to exhaust somewhere. Now, for me, the best place to exhaust this hot, moist air is through the roof. And some people don't like to go through the roof because you have to cut a hole and all that, but I don't find it to be that big a deal. Brone makes a vent kit that works pretty well, and I've used that a few times. That's available at both the big box stores. And what you want to do is just place it somewhere on the roof where it's not too close to the bottom here, you know, usually in the middle to the top area. If you're in an area of the country where there's a lot of snow, try to place it so it's not right next to a wall where a lot of snow might gather. And this method, that the hot, moist air goes on a fairly short run typically and exits quickly, and it's out of the house and gone. Another method that I see, which I don't like as much, is to vent the ductwork through the soffit. So this area right here is the soffit. And so here's your box for the fan. That ductwork comes out and heads down and then exits through the soffit area. The trouble with this is that if you have soffits, typically you also have soffit vents, which are designed for the roof. And if you have a ridge vent up here as well, the idea is that outside air comes up through the soffit vents. There's a chimney effect going up through the roof, and then it exits through the ridge vent. And that keeps the roof cool and the attic cooler. The trouble is, if you're ducting your exhaust fan through this same area, then that hot, moist air is going to come right back into the house. So that's really not a good solution, and I don't care for that. Plus, the connection here through the soffit is often kind of sloppy. I just don't like this method if I can avoid it. There is a few other ways of doing this. If you have a gable sidewall, potentially you can vent through that to the outside. There are fans that go through the wall itself, so you can exhaust, you know, here's the bathroom and you can exhaust through the wall. Those are pretty rare. And there's also another solution where there's a centralized fan. Panasonic makes this for one, and it ducts multiple bathrooms. So you have, you know, ductwork going to each bathroom and then going out the roof or wherever it goes. And that system is very good. It's quiet for sure, but it has its own rules, and you should read the manual because they're very specific about how they want the ductwork to work. But for most people using this typical fan here, usually they sell for $80, $120, somewhere in that range. It's 4-inch ductwork, and you got to do something with it. So the next question, hopefully you're going to go through the roof if you can. And the next question is, where or what kind of duct should you use? There's different types available. So let me show you those. Okay, so for this ductwork here, you have a few different choices. If it's a relatively short run, say, you know, 4 feet to 8 feet, maybe even to 10 feet, you can use this flexible ductwork. Now, the inside of this is rough, and the walls of it are not smooth, so it is going to slow down the air as it passes through. So for longer runs, this is not a great idea. For longer runs, you should use solid wall ductwork. This happens to be my shop dust collecting system, but it's the same type of stuff. So this solid wall ductwork comes in 4-foot sections, usually sometimes longer, and that doesn't slow down the air as it's passing through, so that's better for longer runs. Another option is stuff like this. This is actually designed for air conditioning ductwork, and it typically has a tube in the middle made of plastic with metal rings on it. And what's important is it has insulation on the outside. So for short runs, because this is still pretty rough inside, this is good stuff because it's insulated. So for colder areas, when the hot, moist air comes through the ductwork, it stays hot and exits before it has a chance to condense. I have seen in colder climates, ice blocks develop inside the ductwork just from condensation when it isn't insulated. This same type of insulation, is this like tube insulation, can also be used on this type of duct and also the solid ductwork too. And if you're in a cold area, a cold environment where you have winters, this is definitely a must. You want to use that to make sure you don't get the condensation inside. But for short runs, this kind of stuff is fine. For longer runs, use the smooth metal walls, and that will be a better bet.